What is up, everybody? Welcome back to the homestead. Out here in Idaho, we have a few more weeks left of trapping season. So this morning, we have some brand new traps. We're gonna get them boiled and dyed, possibly waxed, head up on the mountain and get them set.
Hi, we're Mike and Liz. Welcome to Laid Back Living. We do it all here, from DIY construction to the creation of a self-sufficient homestead, and everything in between, including snowmobiling, hunting, and many other outdoor activities that North Idaho offers. Our goal in life is to do as much as we can on our own. Please consider subscribing down below to join in on our adventures.
We got the water warming up back here. Pretty cold outside, so it might take a bit. But out here in Idaho, you have to have some sort of identification, some sort of tag on your trap, saying it's yours. So I'm putting the tags on right now. So we're gonna boil those too. Hopefully the copper holds up. Just copper tags, just attached with a little keychain ring right to the foot trap. Okay, just like that. So we have every trap tagged. We have two different types of traps. We got this other style. This is a long spring trap. These are all number 3 size traps. So we got the long spring trap. Then we got the newer coil spring traps. Another thing you wanna do is have a screw or a nail in there holding those jaws open so you can get water and the dye and the wax throughout everything. There we go. We'll let this do its thing for about 25, 30 minutes. We'll come back, check, see how it's doing. All right, guys, so we have had these boiling for about half an hour now. I'm gonna turn this down. I'm not gonna shut the water off because we wanna keep it warm for the wax and the dye. I'm gonna pull these traps out, let them drip dry inside because I'm pretty sure they'll just freeze outside here. It's pretty chilly, but let's pull these traps, get them hanging inside. All right, guys, next we got the logwood dye. We are just going to pour some of this in. How much is this? Let's see. So 1 pound is good for 36 traps. So we'll put about a third of this in this water here. Okay, so we got that in there. We're gonna let it cook for just a little bit, and then we're gonna bring the traps back out, let them sit in here for a while longer. All right, so we got the traps. They've been sitting in here for a while. Actually, ran out of gas there. Not bad. Okay, then we got just some odorless black trap wax. That's gonna go in there. We're gonna stir that around until this wax melts down. You don't want the water really hot for this, just kind of like a really, really light simmer. This wax is a little bit flammable, so if you happen to have some spill over it, there's a good chance of it catching on fire. All right, we'll give that a bit to let the wax melt down, come back and dip our traps. So it looks like you want to be a little bit quick with the dip. The quicker you go, I think the colder this trap is. So the wax sticks to it pretty good. Those second two I was a lot quicker with than this first one. So I'm going to do this first one just one more time. Man, it actually looks like it got it pretty good. All right, so we got all the traps waxed. We'll let them drip dry right here. Then we'll head up the mountain and get some sets going. All right, guys, so we are out here the next day. We got our traps boiled, waxed, dyed, ready to go. So we're gonna set them out. It's gonna be a little tough because I think the ground's frozen. So we're gonna head up to this one spot where I actually found a natural cubby. We'll get one set there. I think it's gonna be tough, but we'll try to set another one somewhere. It's just tough to find some loose ground right now. So let's head up that way and get that one going and see where the day takes us. All right, guys, so like I was saying, we're out setting traps. For those of you that don't know, this is the backside of our 9-acre homestead. We have a predator running around. We believe it's a bobcat, but today we're out here setting traps. We got about 2 more weeks left of the season. For bobcat and then coyote, we've seen a few coyotes running around. That's open season here, so we're gonna get the trap set up right behind me here. I found a nice little cubby den. I'm gonna dig it out a little bit and set up the first trap. I think first what I'm gonna do is dig this out a little bit with a shovel. All right, so we got this all nice and dug out in there. I'm gonna dig a dirt hole in the back for a bait. Here in Idaho, you have to have your dirt hole covered by something so you can see it's like tucked back in that cubby. So predator birds from up above can't be looking down on this thing. So let's get right to that. All right, so we got our hole dug. I got a nice area here to bed my trap down in. Dig out this trap bed. Take our anchor and bed that right beneath the trap. Carabiner onto our anchor. All right, so we got our trap bedded down in there. You can barely see the edge of the pan right there. Our dirt hole up here. I'm actually gonna move that little stick and that clump of dirt. And then we're gonna put our bait back there. Then we're gonna put a few pieces of stick and clumps of dirt to try to get the animal to walk where we want it to. All right, then we just got some of this stuff. It's like a bobcat lure. So we're gonna put this on like a stick right here. So I'm just gonna take this cap off, stick a stick in there a few times, call it good. And the final ticket is gonna be just a little bit of bobcat urine. Just right next to it there. Right there behind us, we got the trap set. We'll kind of recap what we did. That's a nice little den, so we don't need to cover it. It's covered by any aerial predator birds. They can't see down in here. They shouldn't be able to smell a bait or nothing. So we're covered on that aspect. We dug our dirt hole, dropped an anchor in, set the trap, bedded the trap, buried the trap. We weren't too worried about it because that's a long spring trap down in there. Shouldn't have a huge potential for freezing, especially since the temperatures are starting to get warmer around here. Right now it's about 33 degrees, so we're right in that cusp. We dropped our bait down the hole, and then we put our attractant on two sticks, plus a little bit of bobcat urine right next to it. So we'll see. I think we have a chance of either catching a little bobcat or a coyote in this. Either way is a win-win at this point. Get a few of these predators a little bit further away from the main part of the property. We don't mind having the predators around. It's just when they start to come in close to the house and close to the animals and stuff like that, where we feel it's a little bit of a time to make a move to get them further back. So we got one trap set. Let's move off. We'll set one of these coil spring traps a little bit down further and do all that. That's a pretty decent set. A little bit of commotion, you know, dirt on the fresh snow, tucked into a cubby. All right, as you can see, there's like these old trails down here on the backside of the property. And then there's another one that goes off this way. So this is kind of like an intersection. So that could be a good little spot. A lot of these game animals run the trails. But we're going to head down here a little further on the backside. The reason we're staying on the backside, guys, is because we're trying to keep the dogs from stepping in these traps. The dogs would definitely be curious in what's going on, and chances are they get stuck in the foot trap, which really wouldn't be the end of the world. You can get the dog out. It really doesn't hurt them. But it's a little traumatizing to the dog, obviously. So we're staying on the backside to try to completely prevent any of that. We never bring the dogs back here anyway, even in the winter time especially. So should be almost zero chance of them getting caught in a foot trap. We have no neighbors, so none of their dogs are out running around. Just wild predators, what we're after. All right, we'll do another set right up in here so we don't have to dig out as much snow as last time. This dirt's frozen though. It'll be hard to bed the trap down in that. Scratch that plan. That dirt is way too frozen. So we'll head down this other trail a little bit. Maybe we can find another spot in the trees. See if the dirt isn't super frozen in here. I normally rock the snowshoes, but it's been pretty frozen. I'm gonna have to bust them back out. The ground's getting a lot softer as the day goes on. Well, when the ground's all frozen like that, that makes it super tough to dig traps. That is like concrete, man. It's weird how it's frozen in a lot of spots, but then there's a couple spots that you find that's not that frozen. So super odd, but we got that one trap set over there. We'll check that probably every day here for the next week or two, and then probably reassess after that. Hopefully we can get the ground to thaw here, maybe set a few more other traps, but for now we do have that one just set. Hopefully you guys enjoy this. Hopefully it's a bit of an improvement from our original trapping video. Yeah, and hopefully you enjoyed everything about it. Appreciate you guys watching. We'll catch you in the next one.